Good day, everyone. Welcome to Grade 5 Math Class. I'm your teacher, Connie Salazar. So let's have our new lesson for this week. The PM does rule, GM does rule. So what is this all about? So let's start first. What is M does? That is multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. Our four operations. So ito yung ating tinatanong kapag, what are the four operations? So, para matandaan ninyo, yung word na M does ay multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. So, why do we need to study this rule? So, we are going to perform series of operations. Kaya kailangan natin siyang aralin. So, pagka tayo ay kailangan sumagot o mag-perform ng series of operation, we need a rules. Kailangan may rules tayong susundin to get the correct answer. Kasi kung basta-basta lang natin gagawin, kung alin ang uunahin natin at wala tayong rules na isiset, iba-iba ang magiging sagot natin. MDAS, PMDAS, and GMDAS rules. Identify natin yung tatlong yan. Paano ba yan? Magkakaibay ba? O magkakapare-parehas ng rules? Check natin. Okay. Number one, before we check our rules, kailangan mo munang i-identify yung groupings. Sa MDAS, kailangan nating i-group si MD and AS. So, magkahiwalay sila. Magkasama si multiplication and division, magkasama naman si addition and subtraction. Bakit sila magkasama? Kasi si MD ay equal lang naman kay division, si addition ay equal naman kay subtraction. Paano sila naging equal sa position nila? Pantay sila. Ibig sabihin, pwedeng mauna si division kesa kay multiplication. Hindi ibig sabihin na M does laging nauuna si multiplication kesa kay division at si addition kesa kay subtraction. Dahil sila ang equal, pwedeng mauna ang isa sa kanila, sa kanilang grupo. Paano? Aalimin natin. But before that, let's identify bakit sila ang laging magka-partner. But magka-partner si MD? Bakit hindi M and A, di ba? Pwede naman yun. Ang reason kasi, ang MD and AS, ang tawag sa kanila ay inverse operation. So, what is inverse operation? Means, the operation that reverses the effect of another operation. So, yan yun. So, paano nga ba yan? Anong example natin dyan? Tingnan natin. So, example, 11 times 2, that is 22. So, when you divide 22 by 2, that is 11. And when you divide 22 by 11, that is 2. Because 2 and 11 are factors of 22. So, yun yung reason kung bakit sila ay inverse operation. To check your answer, if it's correct, gagamitin mo si division using our factors para i-check natin ang ating sagot. While in addition and subtraction, let's have example, 9 plus 8, the answer is 17. So, when you subtract 8 from 17, you got 9. Also, when you subtract 9 from 17, you have 8. Kaya, tama yung sagot mo. So, mati-check mo na. Yung addends pala na 9 and 8 ay addends para makuha natin ang 17. Ibig sabihin ng addends, diba? So, therefore, when you get the difference from 17 and 8, that is 9. And when you get the difference from 17 and 9, that is 8. Okay, so alam na ang inverse operation. Let's move on to our first rule, the M does. And then, by the grouping of our M, D, and A, S, because they are equal and rank, so therefore, pwedeng mauna si M kesa kay D or si D kesa kay M, ganun din si A sa S or S kay A. So, paano yun? So, let's start. Okay? The first sample in MD group. Ayan. So, example natin, 16 times 2 divided by 4 equals N. And 16 divided by 2 times 4 equals N. So, paano nga ba yan? So, paano natin sasabihin yung equal ranking niyan? Ibig sabihin, pwede tayong sa 16 times 2 divided by 4, pwede kung 2 divided by 4, mali. So, ang gagawin natin, dahil sila ay equal, we are going to perform from left to right. Bakit? When we write our name, nagsisimula tayo sa left to right, and then pagka nagbabasa rin tayo from left to right, ganun din na gagawin natin sa ating MDAS, PMDAS, GEMDAS rule na mag-i-start tayo lagi sa pag-perform from left to right according to the groupings. Remember, MD group 1 means mauuna muna sila bago kay AS group. Okay, so 16 times 2, that is 32, divide by 4, that is 8. While in the second sample, 16 divide by 2, that is 8, times 4, that is 32. Okay? So, nakita natin yung difference. Ano? Hindi mo pwedeng sabihin na 2 times 4, that is 8. Tapos, saka mo i-divide. Mali. So, magkakaiba tayo. So, para malaman mo kung tama ang rule na to, you can use your calculator to check. Gayahin nyo lang po kung paano natin sinulat yung number sentence. And then, you will see that our answer is correct. Kasi general rule ito. Universal rule ito. Kaya natin ito inaaral kasi ito ay pangkalahatan. Kahit pumunta ka sa ang lugar, kahit tumanda ka na, ito at ito ang ating magiging rule. Wala nang iba pa. Okay, so ito yung rule na meron dyan sa calculator ninyo. Yan ang sinusunod ni calculator na rule. Etong ating rule. Groupings, first in our MD and AS, and then performing from left to right. Okay? So, in example of equal rank in our AS, the example is 9 plus 3 minus 5 equals N. 9 minus 3 plus 5 equals N. So, let's see first our example. From left to right, that is addition. 9 plus 3 equals 12 minus 5, that is 7. While in our second number sentence, 9 minus 3, which is 6 plus 5 equals 11. Okay? So, let's remember, we perform from left to right. Okay, let's start in our MDAS rule. Kasi alam na ninyo kung paano yung equal ranking. So, the first one is you group them by MD and AS. Laging first group muna ang MD, pangalawa si AS. Ibig sabihin nun, lagi nating inuuna yan. Kahit saan nakapwesto si multiplication and division, lagi natin silang uunahing isolve before yung ating addition and subtraction. Then, yung ating equal ranking, and then left to right. Okay? Here's our example. 8 times 3 divided by 4 minus 2 plus 7. So, that is the series operation na sinasabi natin kasi nga hindi lang siya simpleng 8 times 3. Kundi meron pa siyang ibang operation na kasama. At this example, yung 4 operation mismo ang ating kasama sa ating series of operation. Hindi lang dalawa, hindi lang tatlo, kundi full force ang ating 4 operation. The MDAS itself, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. So, anong bang uunahin? Sabi natin, group muna natin, MD and AS. So, MD muna, that is 8 times 3 divided by 4. So, what will we do is to find first the product, then the quotient, the difference, and the sum. So, remember, kapag nagperform tayo ng multiplication, we have our product. And when we perform division, we have our quotient. When we perform subtraction, we have our difference, and we perform addition, we get the sum. Okay, so let's see. Isa-isahin na natin. Paano nga ba natin siya sasagutin? Sabi natin, unahin muna natin si multiplication before division. So, let's start. Yan. So, yung second, 8 times 3, that is 24. Then, copy the remaining operations and digits. Yan. Kung marami pa yung operation and digits, hindi pa natin na-perform, yun lang muna, ikokopyahin natin yun. That's number 2. And then, start na tayo kay division kasi siya pa rin ang una. Diba? Dahil meron tayong groupings, no? Yan yun. 24 divided by 4, that is 6. Then, copy again the remaining operations and digits. Then, perform 6 minus 2 in left to right ulit tayo. Plus 7, that is 11. So, our n is 11. So, always remember that we perform from left to right. Let's have another example. 9 divided by 3 plus 5 times 6 minus 7 equals n. So, what we are going to do? Let's find first the quotient because we start from left. And then, product, then sum, and difference. Bakit nga ba? Kasi, di ba, grinup na natin. Dapat, gagawin muna natin si group 1, multiplication and addition, bago si addition and subtraction. So, divide first, then multiply. So, let's start. 9 divided by 3, that is 3. 5 times 6, that is 30. And then, copy the remaining operation and digit. Okay, so yung plus and subtract 7. Kinopya na natin. Then, from left to right ulit, ang group ng AS, kaya addition muna. That is 33 minus 7 equals 26. So, N is equal to 26. So, hope you understand this first rule in our MDAS rule. Let's move on to PMDAS rule. Ano nga ba yung PMDAS rule? Check what's operation in parentheses or in the parentheses. Kung ano yung nasa loob ng parentheses, yun ang uunahin with the guidance or the rules of MDAS. Check muna natin. And then next is grouping the MD and AS again. And then our example is here. They perform left to right. Okay, 9 divided by 3 times open and close parentheses 5 plus 6 minus 7. So, what we're going to do first is the operation inside the parentheses. So, let's start with 5 plus 6. So, find the sum, then quotient, product, and difference. So, let's start to do our sample. So, sabi nga natin, 5 plus 6 muna, that is 11. Then, copy all the digits and operations na natitira. Then, check natin, ano na bang group ang dapat mauna? That is multiplication and division. Saan ang multiplication and division? That is 9 divided by 3 times 11. So, first, do the left side. That is 9 divided by 3 equals 3, then copy all the remaining digits. So, let's multiply 3 by 11, that is 33. Copy again the 7, minus 33, that is 26. So, always remember again, we perform from left to right according to their group. Hindi lang basta left to right. May groupings tayo. Okay? Next, example, 29 minus 3 times open and close parenthesis 5 plus 7 divide by 2. So, what we're going to do first, that is the 5 plus 7. What is the answer? That is 12. Then, copy all the digits. So, what we're going to do next, the MD group, multiply and divide. Dahil sa nasa left side si multiplication din, we will multiply 3 times 12, that is 36. Then copy, then divide first the 36 by 2, that is 18, subtract by 29, that is 11. So our n is 11. So we find the sum, product, quotient, and difference. Let's move on to our GMDAS. What is our rule in GMDAS? Siyempre, meron uli siyang parenthesis. Ganun pa rin, igugroup pa rin natin siya, tapos alam naman natin yung equal ranking and doing the left to right process. So, let's have our example. 9 divided by 3 times bracket 2 times open and close parenthesis minus 6 plus 8. Kung titingnan ninyo, meron ng nasa loob. May grouping siya inside the parenthesis. Hindi lang siya simpleng pinarenthesis, kundi may operation pa siya at may isa pa siyang parenthesis. So, let's start first in the inner. Parang tayo, hindi tayo pumupunta sa labas ng bahay at dun tayo magsusuklay, dun tayo magsasuot ng damit. Kailangan muna nating magpaganda sa loob ng bahay bago tayo lumabas. So, ganun din tayo sa pag nag-perform tayo sa ating GMDAS rule. Titingnan muna natin yung pinaka nasa loob bago tayo lalabas. So, let's start first by finding the difference. Then, the product, kasi yun ang nasa close parenthesis, ano? Then, quotient, product again, and the sum. So, let's see nga kung mape-perform natin ang sunod-sunod dyan. Tingnan na natin. Okay, sabi natin, ang mauuna, yung nasa pinakaloob, that is 9 minus 6, that is 3. And then, copy, nasa loob pa rin, di pa tayo lumalabas, 2 times 3, that is 6. So, ngayon, nasa labas na tayong lahat. So, i-group naman natin siya by MD and AS. So, ang M and D natin, ang nauna ay division dahil nasa left side. So, 9 divided by 3, that is 3 times 6 plus 8 kasi kakopy muna natin. Ano? Then, perform again the multiplication, that is 18 plus 8 equals 26. So, diba, perform natin yung difference, then product in the parentheses, then quotient, product again, and the sum. Then we get the final answer, 26. Not so hard. It's so easy. Just follow our rules. Okay? I-remember nyo lang yung rules. Hindi kayo magkakamali. Okay? Our example, 5 times 3 minus open and close parenthesis, 24 minus 4 times 3. Divide by 3. Ito na yung sinasabi din natin, no? Another way ng groupings. Nasa loob kasi ng parenthesis ay hindi lang isang operation, kundi group of operation din siya. Kaya grouping siya, GMDAS siya. Kasi nakagroup siya. So, unahin muna natin yung loob muna uli bago tayo lalabas. So, ano bang mauna? Laging remember, M, D, A, S. Multiplication and division, group bago ang addition and subtraction. So, unahin muna natin si multiplication. So, 4 times 3, that is 12. Copy mo uli. And nasa loob pa uli siya ng parenthesis. So, 24 minus 12, that is 12. Copy mo uli ang remaining. And then, do the multiplication and then the division before the subtraction. So, 5 times 3, that is 15. 12 times divide by 3, that is 4. Then subtract, that is 11. So, always remember that we perform from left to right. Basta, MD and AS, don't forget. So, thank you. Congratulations. Hope you understand our lesson. And, may pahabol. Remember yung sabi ko sa inyo, our assignment, we will check it on our next meeting. So don't forget to like, subscribe my channel. And thank you for supporting me and listening to our lesson for the day. So asahan ko yan na, kids. Sasagutan at iti-check natin to sa ating meeting. Congratulations! Uli, sana naintindihan, and God bless. And always remember, for with God, nothing is impossible. Luke 1 verse 37. So, lagi niyong tatandaan yan, kids. Hope you understand our lesson. And thank you so much. God bless. Bye-bye.